space and time were both severely damaged when the Lost Hour came back.
Only to have them fight to the death? Hell of a hobby. What's he planning to do? Create a new species to replace humankind?
Deactivated.
Not all his creations seem to be a success. This is where you'll find his failed subjects, grown wild and mad due to the force of the chaos.
Failed subjects just like us. Humans are stained with the chaos that gives us our hearts and souls. That's the reason why we fight. Wild and mad. Sometimes even turning on our maker.
I wonder if God was trying to make people into humans, with hearts and minds of their own, but without the stain of Etro's touch.
No, that's not what he was trying to create. He wanted to make something better than humans, something much more powerful. A being that would possess chaos, and yet hold possibilities humans never had. At the heart of this hellish place should be the strongest beast of all, the closest God ever came to his perfect being.
Go to hell.
job. Time to mix it up.
Such a thing.
For God, we humans are nothing but tools. If you wanted sturdier tools that wouldn't break under pressure, these would do.
So what you're saying is that if God grows tired of us being troublesome, our replacements will be on the sidelines waiting to take our future.
Don't worry. I think I can take care of that. I'll destroy this ultimate creation of God's and prove to him just what we humans are capable of. Down. You can't read me. This'll do. Price. You think you can be forgiven? Shine on me. Thing.
Relight the chaos.
Release the light. Thank you. wraps it up. Even in this dying world, plenty of people still believe in God. They believe they are special, and that God loves them unconditionally. They believe He is looking out for them. Gods exist, all right, but they've got their own agenda. They sure didn't make this world and put people in it because they love us. They just wanted to create new tools.
But now those same tools have defeated the beast of God. With that victory, he is forced to recognize the strength of humanity. You yourself are the proof of humanity's promise and potential. You want a future for humanity.
Did it mean anything, though? Sure, I showed God what I'm capable of, but the power I used to defeat the beast wasn't any kind of human power. I won a victory, but what am I? Am I still human? Can I still be called a child of man?